In other news, authorities say a Metro East woman was running an online boutique where she was selling stolen merchandise from her basement.
Now, but tonight, she's behind bars after pleading guilty in a separate stealing case. Fox 2's Chris Renier is live in Chesterfield with the amazing pictures of what was found. Chris.
Vic and Jasmine, we are just outside the Chesterfield Police Department. Detectives here have been instrumental in this investigation. Authorities seized thousands of dollars worth of stolen merchandise from this woman's home. In fact, police here say the woman hit virtually all of the retail areas in Chesterfield.
I described it as QVC of stolen clothes. I mean, she had the things set up and things she was planning on selling that day.
Chesterfield Police Sergeant Keith Ryder is talking about all of this stolen merchandise. It was seized by authorities last November at the East St. Louis home of 29-year-old Tawana Trotter. Ryder says investigators found some $20,000 worth of stolen merchandise in the home. Ryder tells us Trotter and others would steal the merchandise from stores in communities including Chesterfield. Then Trotter would go on Facebook Live and try to sell it.
She basically had a boutique set up in her basement where she would advertise what she had and show them on the live video, and I guess hoping for people to come and buy those products for her.
Ryder says his detectives would actually watch Trotter's Facebook Live sessions to see what she was selling.
The products that they observed she was selling, we were able to trace back to actually stolen from retail areas in Chesterfield as well as throughout St. Louis County and also as far as Osage Beach.
Ryder calls Trotter a professional shoplifter and says she has been arrested multiple times for retail theft cases in Chesterfield. Thursday, she pled guilty and was sentenced to 4 years in prison for cases including a 2018 theft at this Chesterfield Walmart.
She pled guilty to a case we had where her and a co-defendant pushed out a large amount of items from Walmart without paying for them.
Ryder hopes Trotter being off the streets will put a dent in the shoplifting problem around the St. Louis area.
You don't want that out in your community, out there at your retail areas.
A total of 414 items were seized during that November search of Trotter's home. Ryder says that case is still currently under investigation by authorities in Illinois. We're told no charges have been filed yet in connection with that search and seizure. For now, live in Chesterfield, Chris Renier, Fox News.